Hey, what's going on, Bully World? How you guys doing? This is Zeke, Bully Badass TV. In this community, in the dog breeding community, the worst thing you can call somebody basically is a backyard breeder. Now, I'll be the first to admit that within the American bully community, there are way too many backyard breeders. But this is the cool thing about being a backyard breeder. It's not something that you're born to be. It's not something that only a few people, you know, that most people have to be, or it takes millions and millions of dollars not to be a backyard breeder. Really, the difference between being a backyard breeder and a reputable breeder is simply your mindset. Once you fix your mind to the fact that you're going to be ethical, you're going to do good business, you're going to be morally responsible to the animals that you create, pretty much at that point in time, once you accept those realities, you'll move into the position of being a reputable breeder. And like I said, there's far too many backyard breeders in the American bully community. No matter what they want to tell you, no matter what they want to post on our YouTube channels, backyard breeding isn't a specific problem to this community. But what I want to do here, because we want to speak positivity into our universe, into our world, into our community, I found this article on pawrescue.com, and they basically list the things that reputable breeders do, and these are the things that basically define reputable breeding. So I want all of you guys, if you are breeding, I'm not necessarily encouraging anyone to breed. It's a hard thing. It's a high calling, in my opinion, creating life. So if it's not something that you really want to do or something that you think it's about doing for money, I would suggest that you not breed. But if you are breeding, if you want to breed and you're dead set on doing it, you should be a reputable breeder. So here's a list of things that reputable breeders do. The first thing it says is that reputable breeders do not sell their puppies through pet stores. A reputable breeder creates a puppy. He creates a life. He wants to basically take his creation, see the person, see the family that he's going to give that creation to, and know that his creation is going to be safe and well cared for. Second, reputable breeders don't breed multiple breeds. They usually stick to one or two, but to get into the point where you go to a kennel or someone's yard and they got 5, 6, 7 different breeds of dogs, it's just too much information. You know, basically they become probably a puppy mill, but the other thing is a jack of all trades and a master of none. For that reason, reputable breeders tend to limit the breeds of dogs that they deal with to one or two breeds. And usually those breeds will be somewhat, they will relate to one another. Like for example, if you're breeding American Bulldogs, you might breed Old English Bulldogs, or you may breed Pit Bulls and Amstaff, American Pit Bull Terriers and Amstaff. Those breeds are very similar, so that wouldn't be such a stretch. Most reputable breeders, that is, are involved in some sort of organization in dealing with dog showing, whether it be, you know, like the AKC or ABKC dog show, confirmation show, or whether it be sporting events, protection events or whatever, even athletic events like dock diving. Typically, if you're breeding dogs for a specific purpose, a reputable breeder will then also take his productions, his puppies, or his dogs rather, and have them compete in that sport or that activity. Reputable breeders value their reputation and seek to improve the breed. Now, what that means is, I don't know if you guys saw this video I did like a year ago, and it says that, you know, the calling of any breeder, any breeding, is to improve the breed or to improve the dog. Really, it's to improve the breed. So that means that you don't produce dogs that don't add value to the breed as it currently exists. And this is a long list of things. So obviously, being a reputable breeder takes a lot of dedication and a lot of planning. Because you don't necessarily, we're going to keep moving, but this is quite a bit of stuff. The next thing that a reputable breeder does that a backyard breeder would not do is provide full lifetime written guarantees covering genetic diseases and temperament problems. Again, anybody selling you a dog, they're reputable, should be willing to take that dog back if you have any legitimate issues with the dog that are genetic-based or temperament-based. Reputable breeders place all pet quality animals with a contract requiring that the purchaser not breed the puppy. So that puppy must be spay or neutered. When you're dealing with a reputable breeder, they should provide you with a lifetime of quality advice and assistance in raising any dog that they sold to you. Again, a reputable breeder, when he creates life, mentally, spiritually, he should be connected to the animal for as long as that animal is around. So that means, you know, if you have an issue where there might be an issue that might be specific to a breed that you haven't encountered before, you should be able to call up that breeder that you bought the dog from and ask him, how do I deal with this problem? And he should be very willing to give you as much time and all his resources to solve that problem because, again, he created that animal and he should want nothing but the best for that animal. The next thing they have on this list is that whenever you go to buy a puppy, the mother of that dog, at least the mother of the dog, should be on the premises and she should be there for you to inspect and kind of observe her overall health and her behavior. Reputable breeders only breed dogs over 2 years of age and only breed them a limited number of times, not every year, like some people will do within the American bully community. That's not, you know, that's not a best practice. And again, if you want to, another thing, if you want to be a reputable breeder, you need to line up your buyers before you create the puppies. That way you're not necessarily having to deal with the issue of, you know, you had a litter of 8 puppies, you're able to sell 2, now you have 6 that you're either going to have to place or you're going to have to, you know, turn over to some rescue. Reputable breeders do not breed dogs that end up in rescues. That's just not the intentions of a reputable breeder. Okay, a reputable breeder should not ever sell you a puppy before the puppy is eight weeks old. You know, obviously that 8 weeks is really crucial for the puppy's connection to the mother. There's a lot of genetic and social and just dog information being transpired between the mom and the pup. So you shouldn't be able to get a puppy, and no reputable breeder is going to sell you a puppy before the puppy's 8 weeks old. The last thing that they have on this list in terms of defining a reputable breeder is that a reputable breeder will be able to provide you with tons of happy puppy buyers, recommendations from happy puppy buyers. These are people who are willing to state that not only did the breeder do good business at the initial sale, but has been there, has been a part of the life in terms of whether it be advice and resources of that puppy since he was born. So those, my friends, are kind of, that's a long list. And that list being long is important and really shows that, again, being a breeder is not a get-rich-quick scheme. It's really a moral and ethical commitment to animals, to your customers, and at the end of the day, to society, because a lot of the dogs that are bred and end up in these rescues, we all pay for it, one way or the other. So I would just suggest that if you are going to breed, I'm going to suggest that most people not breed. But if you are going to breed and you are going to, you know, you're dead set on it, check out that link. Understand that breeding is not a get-rich-quick scheme. There's heavy costs to pay in breeding. And if you are going to do it, you should do it as a reputable breeder. All right, this is Zeeck. This is Bully Badass TV. Peace.